As a car guy, I'm quite sad that the compact SUV is taking over the car market. If you look at the sales figures of the Hyundai Creta or the Kia Seltos, I'm sure your jaw will drop to the floor just like mine did. Yes, compact SUVs are super practical, loaded with features, and are great for the city. But all that comes at the cost of a small engine and little to no driving pleasure. And obviously at the cost of quite a lot of money. Around 20 lakhs for a decent variant depending on which car you're getting. But what if I tell you that you can get a sports car with a big engine for the same price?
This is a 2008 Nissan 350Z convertible. It's no secret that a front engine, rear wheel drive two-seater is going to be a hell of a fun car to drive. And the 350Z is super capable as well. With a great history in sports like Formula Drift, this thing has proven itself time and time again. It has a 3.5-litre naturally aspirated V6 engine which produces around 300 horsepower, and it's a recipe for the purists.
Now, this particular example might not be the ideal choice for someone who is looking for a proper hunkered down, clip the apex experience, because this is the convertible and more importantly, this is an automatic. Nonetheless, it is a super fun car to throw around with a raspy engine note and a communicative steering. The 350Z is quite heavy for a sports car though, weighing in around 1600 kilograms, but that massive weight figure is offset by the 350Z's beautiful weight distribution. More on that later.
The 350Z was introduced back in 2003, and yeah, the design is almost 20 years old, but it's still contemporary and works in today's day and age. It has aged very gracefully. The wide arches at the back, the long bonnet and the short overhangs. It's a very classic looking sports car. The 350Z's interior is where the car shows its age a little bit, but it's not an impractical place at all. You have loads of place to keep stuff around, like this center armrest, this one over here on the center console, and it's a little bit old-fashioned with this JVC audio system over here, and it looks super retro. The driving position is very driver-oriented. You have these three dials which has your battery voltage, oil, and this thing which I don't really know what it is because the car is not started. And you have this beautiful analog instrument cluster in front of you, which shows you a big tachometer in the middle and your speedometer on the right-hand side. I love the driving position of this car and the analog speedometer and tachometer. Since this is the convertible, you have endless amounts of headroom because the sky is your limit. You have a button which you press and the top goes up. It takes about 20 seconds for the top to go up. And once you have the top down and you don't want wind buffeting noise in the car, you have this small little glass over here which will deflect the air and make it a very quiet place inside where you can have a normal conversation as well. So yeah, the 350Z's interior is a throwback to the early 2000s.
This car has a decent amount of front-end mechanical grip. It comes only with traction control and no other type of wizardry, but since the engine is so close to me, this is a very well-balanced chassis thanks to all of the heavy mass being concentrated towards the middle, which also makes it quite predictable and gives the driver much more, let's say, room for error. The 350Z sits upon Nissan's ubiquitous FM platform. This high fidelity setup offers an aluminum multi-link suspension front and rear and an engine position set so far back in the chassis that the M stands for mid-engine. Although it shares platform with Nissan's company sedans, the 350Z is wonderfully balanced, perfectly poised pavement partner.
Well, this is the party piece of the Nissan 350Z, the VQ35 engine, and you get two sorts of VQ35s in the Nissan 350Z, the VQ35DE and the VQ35HR, HR standing for high rev, and it being the more potent engine with 80% of its internals being different from the DE. The thing is, this engine in itself is quite legendary. Yeah, it might not be able to make the 1000 horsepower that your two JZs and the RB26 makes, but the thing is, this engine is much lighter than those two engines because it's made out of aluminum, whereas those engines are made out of iron blocks. That's why those engines can withstand that much amount of horsepower. But this, in America and in other places where the 350Z was sold in masses, this was one of the easiest ways to make cheap horsepower. And that's because the VQ35 is one of the most versatile engines out there. You can turbocharge them, supercharge them, you can take the internals to great lengths to get tons and tons of power out of them. And the engineers at Nissan have done a great job in engineering this engine. This is one of the most balanced engines you can get out there. The pistons and the other engine components work in tandem to make one of the smoothest running engines anywhere else in the world. And that's the thing, the VQ35 engine has a very distinct sound to it. It has a sound that no other V6 has. And it sounds absolutely glorious. The 350Z's heart is young, fit and free. Well, free revving that is. It is one of the easiest ways to get a proper Japanese sports car experience in a budget. And with the capabilities of mods, customization and other performance gains almost endless with this car, this is one hell of a bargain with this particular example, which is in almost pristine condition being sold at 19 lakh rupees. And yeah, you get one proper thoroughbred Japanese sports car.
Before I sign off, a big shout out to the Stallion Club for providing us with this beautiful Nissan 350Z. They have a lot of quirky cars for sale on their page. Go check them out on Instagram. Everything from a Mitsubishi FTO to a Land Rover Freelander to this Nissan 350Z. Give them a follow and check out the deals that they have available. Also, follow us on Instagram. We're trying to reach 5,000 followers on Instagram as soon as possible. And give us a subscribe on YouTube if you haven't already. We're posting a lot of content even through these tough times. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.